Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Himanshu Arora from Department of Anthropology, University of Delhi. Today, I am going to speak on the module Occupational Health and Anthropology from the paper Applied Anthropology. First of all, we'll look into the learning objectives of this module. In this module, the learner will be able to understand the notion of occupational health. They will be able to know about the causes and the types of stress experienced at a workplace. They will be able to explore the role of occupational health. They will be able to gain insights about the universal health coverage of workers. Now, first of all, let us discuss about the general concepts of occupational health. Occupational health is a special branch of medicine that focuses on the physical and mental well-being of employees in the workplace. Occupational health refers to the identification and controlling the risks arising from any physical, chemical, and other workplace hazards in order to establish and maintain a safe and healthy working environment. These hazards may include chemical agents and solvents, heavy metals such as lead and mercury, physical agents such as loud noise or vibration, physical hazards such as electricity or dangerous machinery. According to National Institute of Occupational Health, occupational health is a sustained activity aimed at promotion and maintenance of highest degree of physical, mental, and social well-being of workers in all occupations. So, occupational health deals with the aspects related to health and safety in a workplace. It has a strong focus on primary prevention of hazards. Since 1986, the National Institute of Environment Health Sciences has supported training and educational program designed to protect workers and their communities from exposure to toxic materials encountered during hazardous waste operations and chemical emergency response. This includes safety and health training for workers which are involved in hazardous waste removal and comprehensive training and environmental restoration for residents living near heavily polluted industrial waste sites. Now, let us see what are the determinants which the workplace conditions may affect the health of the workers. The health of the workers has several determinants such as the risk factors at workplace leading to cancer, accidents, musculoskeletal diseases, respiratory diseases, hearing impairment or its complete loss, circulatory diseases, stress-related disorders, communicable diseases, and others. Employment and working condition in any formal or informal economy embrace other important determinants like working hours, salary, policies at workplace, promotion, protection provisions, etc. A healthy job is likely to be the one where the pressure on employees is appropriate in relation to their abilities and resources, the amount of control they have over their work, and the support they receive from people who matter to them. As health is not merely the absence of disease or infirmity, but a positive state of total physical, mental, and social well-being. So, a healthy working environment is characterized by an abundance of health-promoting conditions and absence of harmful ones. It may include a continuous assessment of risk to health, a provision of appropriate information and training on health issues, and the availability of health promoting organizational support practices and structures. A healthy work environment is one where the staff is able to achieve health, where the health promotion is a priority and part of their working lives. Pressure and stress. Stress arises in a wide range of working conditions. However, it is often made worse when the employees feel they have little support from their supervisors and colleagues, along with little control over the work processes. Work-related stress is a response to the work demands and pressures that arise when expectations are not matched with the knowledge and abilities of the employee, that consequently challenge their ability to cope with the stress. Pressure at workplace is unavoidable due to the demands of the contemporary work environment. Pressure identified as acceptable by an individual may even keep workers alert, motivated, able to work and learn, depending on the available resources and personal characteristics. However, when that pressure becomes excessive or otherwise unmanageable, it leads to stress. Stress can damage an employee's health as well as business performance and productivity. Work-related stress can be caused by poor work organization, the way jobs and work systems are designed, and the way we manage them. Poor work design, for example, lack of control over work processes, poor management, unsatisfactory working conditions, lack of support from colleagues and supervisors. Research findings have shown that the most stressful type of work is the one that values excessive demands and pressure which are not matched to workers' knowledge and abilities, where there is little opportunity to exercise any choice or control and little support is gained from others. Employees are less likely to experience work-related stress when demands and pressure of work are matched to their knowledge and abilities. Control can be exercised over their work and the way they do it. Appropriate support is received from supervisors and colleagues, and participation in decisions that concern their jobs is provided. Stress-related hazards at work. Stress-related hazards at work can be divided into work content and work context. Work content include job content like monotony, understimulation, meaningless of task, lack of variety, etc. Workload and work pace like too much or too little to do, work under time pressure, etc. Working hours, strict or inflexible, long and unsocial, unpredictable, badly designed shift systems, participation and control, lack of participation in decision making, lack of control over work processes, pace, hours, methods, and the work environment. Work context includes career development, status and pay, like job insecurity, lack of promotion opportunities, under or over promotion, work of low social value, piece rate payment schemes, unclear or unfair performance evaluation systems, being over or under skilled for a job, role in the organization like unclear role, conflicting roles, interpersonal relationships like inadequate, inconsiderate or unsupportive supervision, poor relationship with colleagues, bullying or harassment and violence, isolated or solitary work, organizational culture like poor communication, poor leadership, lack of behavioral rule, lack of clarity about organizational objectives, structures and strategies, work-life balance like conflicting demands of work and home, lack of support for domestic problems at work, lack of support for work problems at home, lack of organizational rules and policies to support work-life balance. Now let's discuss about the aims of occupational health. The aim of occupational health is to prevent work-related illness and injury by encouraging safe working practices, designing ergonomically efficient and comfortable workstations, monitoring the health of workforce, supporting the management of sickness or absence. An occupational health service also helps in following ways, like work with the employer in implementing policies and ensure health and safety compliance, conduct pre-employment health assessments, support health promotion and education programs, provide advice and give counseling to employees about non-health related problems, provide the employer with advice and guidance about making reasonable adjustments to the working conditions. Occupational health provision in a company depends upon the size of the organization. In such a setting, it could be made available by a range of specialists, including physiotherapists, hygienists, psychologists, ergonomic experts, occupational therapists, specialized occupational health nurses and doctors. All such provisions must be provided to each and every employee by their employers. If such provisions are not available at the employing institution, then one can seek help from external occupational health care providers. It has been noticed that occupational health problems occur mainly during performing a task at workplace or because of the kind of work that a person does. These problems can include cuts, broken bones, sprains and strains, loss of limbs, repetitive motion disorders, hearing problems caused by exposure to noise, vision problems, illness caused by breathing, touching or swallowing unsafe substances, illness caused by exposure to radiation, exposure to germs in healthcare settings. Therefore, safety at the workplace and practices for prevention of mishapness can reduce the risk of incidence of these problems. One should try to stay fit, reduce stress, set up the work area properly and use the right equipment and gear. Staying safe at workplace. Staying safe at workplace is very important. If one does not work in a safe way, then he or she can get hurt or become sick. However, by taking the following precautions both at workplace and home could lower the chances of getting hurt. You can see the important precautions to be taken. Precautions to prevent injuries at work, like lifting things safely, arranging equipments to fit the body, taking short breaks and stretch, wearing protective equipments, complete information about health resources at work. Since the overall health of a person also affects the performance at workplace and how the person feels, therefore to be able to work safely, it is important to get enough sleep, to eat a healthy diet, to stay active, keeping a watch at your weight, manage stress. All types of job, even desk jobs, can lead to injuries. Back injuries in the form of lower back pain and stiffness are the most important type of workplace injury. One is at a risk of getting hurt at place if the person lifts or carries heavy objects. This can strain or injure the back, shoulders or neck. Repeating the same activity over and over again, like typing or working or on an assembly line, this can cause what is called repetitive motion injury. Not wearing the right protective equipment for the work one does, like earplugs or safety goggles, taking steps to stay safe and healthy at work can help to get more work done and giving an overall better feeling. While lifting something heavy, one must bend at knees, not at the waist, keep the back straight. Test the object first. If it is too heavy, get help. Wear protective equipment. Wearing protective equipment can lower the chance of injury. Protective equipment includes the following: earplugs, safety goggles, work gloves, hard hats. Let us have a glance at the common sanctions of occupational health. Following is a list of do's and don'ts of the practices and activities that could be undertaken at a workplace so as to lead a safe, healthy, stress-free work life. to take the time to arrange the equipment that fits your body. Do not try to adjust your body to work with equipment that is not set up right for you. Talk with your boss or employer about how to make sure your equipment is set up correctly. Sit or stand upright while you work. If you sit, adjust the chair or desk to your height. If you use tools or equipment, put them where you can easily reach them. Take breaks often when doing repetitive tasks. Warm up and stretch before start working. Bursitis and tendinitis are the two common conditions that repetitive motion can cause. So take short breaks. Even a 5-minute break can help increase concentration and reduce stress. Take short breaks often and stretch or go for a walk. Understand the resources available at the work. Many employers offer free programs that could help stay healthy. So one must find out what resources are available. Even if the help is not needed right then, get enough sleep. Getting a good night's sleep every night is important for performing well at workplace. After resting well enough, a person is likely to make good decisions and avoid getting hurt. To sleep better, do not eat a big meal close to bedtime. Stay away from drinks with caffeine like coffee, soda, energy drinks several hours before going to sleep. Get regular physical activity, but do not exercise right before you go to bed. Make sure your bedroom is dark and quiet. Stay healthy. A healthy body helps in protecting or faster recovery from injuries on the job. To stay in shape, one must eat healthy, as our body needs the right vitamins, minerals and other nutrients to stay healthy. Get active to get the health benefits of physical activity. Do a combination of aerobic and muscle strengthening activities. Watch your weight. To stay at a healthy weight, balance the calories you eat with the calories you use. Steps should be taken to manage stress. Chronic stress at work or at home can increase the risk of getting sick or hurt. Stress could be reduced by planning ahead, noticing when you feel stressed and taking time to relax. Universal health coverage of workers. Presently, only 15% of workers worldwide have access to specialized occupational health services, carrying out prevention of occupational risk, health surveillance, training in safe working methods, first aid, and advising employers in occupational health and safety. More attention should be given to the psychological work conditions of the workers and employees in organizations in order to prevent poor work ability. It is a statutory and moral responsibility of the employer to safeguard the health, safety, and welfare of workers and to take reasonably practicable steps to prevent avoidable injuries. There has been considerable reduction in the physical demands of most workers, and much effort has gone into ergonomic improvements that have reduced many serious occupational health risks. Resolution WHA, Workers' Health Global Plan of Action, urged the member states to work towards full coverage of all workers, including those in the informal economy, small and medium-sized enterprise, agriculture, and migrant and contractual workers with essential interventions and basic occupational health services. This would help in primary prevention of occupational and work-related diseases and injuries. WHO Secretariat was requested to develop timeline and indicators to establish occupational health services for everyone at the global level. WHO's work on extending access to the most essential health interventions and services for workers' health include enabling primary care centers to deliver preventive, curative, and rehabilitation people-centered care according to the specific health needs of working people, particularly those who do not have access to occupational health services. Strengthening the specialized occupational health services, multidisciplinary and basic, and improving their link to primary care centers and to the rest of the health system. Stimulating international efforts to build human resource capacities for workers' health, both in primary care and occupational health specialists. At the World Day for Safety and Health Work, celebrated on 28th April 2014, WHO called for scaling up of workers' health coverage. On the occasion, WHO urged countries and the global community to extend health coverage of all the workers, including farmers and artisans, as well as contractual and migrant workers in the informal sectors. Now let us summarize what we have learned in this module. Occupational health refers to the identification and controlling the risk arising from any physical, chemical and other workplace hazards in order to establish and maintain a safe and healthy working environment. Health is not merely the absence of disease but a positive state of total physical, mental and social well-being. When the workplace pressure becomes excessive or otherwise unmanageable, it leads to stress. Employees are less likely to experience work-related stress when demands and pressure of work are matched to their knowledge and abilities. Control can be exercised over their work and the way they do it. Support is received from the supervisors and colleagues, and participation in decisions that concern their jobs is provided. Occupational health provisions not only work at individual level but are also active at the organizational level in the form of various health specialists. It is a statutory and moral responsibility of the employers to safeguard the health, safety and welfare of workers and to take reasonably practicable steps to prevent avoidable injuries. In this regard, World Health Association has urged its member states to work towards full coverage of all workers, including those in the informal economy, small and medium-sized enterprise, agriculture and migrant and contractual workers, with essential interventions and basic occupational health services. This would help in primary prevention of occupational and work-related diseases and injuries. Thank you.